friends, Pastor Doug Batchelor. We want to welcome you to our Friday evening Bible question of the week, where now we're going to consider the big question, was the Apostle Peter the first pope? And are all of the subsequent popes now following in the succession of Peter? Did Jesus give Peter the keys to the kingdom? This, of course, is a foundational teaching in the Roman Catholic Church. And the big question is it biblical? Now, just in case you're wondering, here's what the official teaching is in the church. The Bishop of Rome has a right to the primacy above the universal church since he is the successor of St. Peter, who received such prerogatives from Jesus Christ. And they go on to teach that if anyone shall say that the Roman pontiff is not the successor of the blessed Peter in his primacy, let him be anathema, that is to be declared a heretic. That's from the First Vatican Council that you have in 1870. You see, to millions of Catholics around the world, this is a binding teaching. However, the question needs to be asked, is it a biblical teaching? And I remember I had an uncle and wasn't very religious most of his life, sort of surprised everybody when near the end of his life, he said he wanted to be confirmed and baptized as a Catholic. And I thought, oh, uncle, I would love to have studied with you. Let's study the Bible together. He said, no, Doug, I can't study your religion. Only the Catholic Church can trace its heritage back unbroken to the Apostle Peter. He had been taught this doctrine and he thought all these other churches popped up through history, but the only church that has unbroken succession back to the beginning is the Catholic Church. Is that true? Well, a lot of this misunderstanding is based upon a passage that you find in the book of Matthew chapter 16, verse 13. So let's read that together. I'll start with Matthew 16, verse 13. So when Jesus came into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples saying, who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? So they said, some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. And so he said to them, but who do you say that I am? Simon Peter answered and said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said to him, blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And also I say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. And so this is the passage where they're saying, Jesus said right there, you're Peter. And on this rock of Peter, I'm going to build my church. Is that what Christ is saying? Did Jesus really build his church on the apostle Peter? If you ask which of the apostles was the loosest canon of them all, you'd say, Peter. Which of the apostles opened his mouth and inserted his foot over and over again? Peter. And if you look in the very same passage, just jump down to verse 22, Matthew 16, we're still in the same chapter. And it says here, I'll start with verse 21. From that time, Jesus began to show his disciples he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and the chief priests and the scribes, be killed and rise the third day. Then Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, saying, far be it from you, Lord, this shall not happen to you. But he, Jesus, turned and said to Peter, get thee behind me, Satan. You are an offense to me, for you are not mindful of the things of God, but the things of men. And so it's mind-boggling to me that the Catholic Church would teach that here in one passage, he's saying, I'm going to build my church on the rock of Peter. You read a few verses and Jesus is calling Peter Satan. No. What was Christ saying? When Peter said, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus is saying, who do you say that I am? Peter said, you are the Christ. You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. Christ then says, notice the wording. He said, Simon Bar-Jonah, blessed are you, for flesh and blood did not reveal that to you. And now I'm in verse 18. And I say to you that you are Peter. Now, the word Peter there is Petros. That's very important, Petros. It means a chip off the old block. It means a rock, a rolling stone, a piece of a rock. So very big distinction here. I say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. two very different words are being used. He says, you are Peter, and that word there is Petros. Petros means a chip off the old block. It means a piece of a rock, a rolling stone, a rock that you can throw from one place to another, a rock that can be rolled in the waves. It's a small rock. But then he says, but upon this rock, this Petra, and the Petras is a rock of immense proportions. You're talking there about Half Dome. You're talking about the Prudential Rock. You're talking about the Straits of Gibraltar, the Gates of Hercules, a rock of immense proportions. Jesus said, on this declaration that you've made, Peter, I am going to build my church. Jesus is not building the church on the Apostle Peter. Now, how do we know this? Well, there's several ways we know this. We're going to let the Bible explain it. First of all, Peter did not interpret it that way. If you look in Peter's writings, he said, Christ alone is the rock upon which we build the church. He never said, I am the rock upon which we build the church. And you can just look in 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 4 through 8 to find that. The other apostles were present that day. How did they interpret? They all heard it. How did they interpret that statement? Did they interpret that statement that, okay, from now on, we're going to bow down to Peter. He is going to be the rock upon which Jesus builds the church. No, right up to the very end, you see Matthew 20, verse 20, Matthew 9, verse 33, Luke 22, verses 24 through 26. The disciples were all arguing among themselves which of them was the greatest. If Jesus had said Peter was going to be the greatest, then why would that happen? How did the Apostle Paul view it? Did he think that Peter was to be the new head of the church? No, Paul makes it pretty clear that the church actually had several pillars. He said, well, Peter is a pillar, and James is a pillar, and John is a pillar. And he said, Jesus is the cornerstone for the church. And Paul rebukes Peter for his hypocritical behavior when he was hanging out with the Jews in Asia. And so if he thought that Peter is a pillar upon which the church is resting, and if Peter is, you know, flawless and he doesn't make a mistake, say the Catholic Church believes because it retains the succession and authority of Peter, that when the Pope speaks ex cathedra, that means on the throne, so to speak, that these are like the words of God, and he can even overrule Scripture. Peter didn't view that, and Paul didn't view it that way. Even most of the early church fathers, and catch this, even Augustine, who the Catholics view as one of the great church fathers, he viewed that that word Petra, upon which the church was built, is talking about Christ, not Peter. And so it's only more recently in Catholic history they began to adopt that position. Jesus, he actually said that Peter was unstable. He would not build the church upon him. He said, Peter, your faith is on the verge of failing, but I prayed for you that you're converted and your faith does not fail. Did Jesus build his church on one of the apostles he said was not even thoroughly converted until after the crucifixion? And something else you should take into mind, that if the popes are the succession of the example of Peter, why don't they marry? Peter was married. You can read here in 1 Corinthians 9:5, do not we have a right to take along a believing wife, as do the other apostles, the brothers of the Lord, in Peter? Matthew 8, verse 14, now when Jesus had come into Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother lying sick. So how can the Pope say we're following the example of Peter? If you really want to know, if there was one of the early apostles that you would call the head of the church, it wasn't Peter, it was not John, it was not Matthew, it was not Paul, it was probably James, not James the brother of John, but James the brother of Jesus. Because you can read, look here, in Acts 12, 17, and he, Peter, said, go tell these things to James and the brethren. James was often referred to as sort of the chairman of the board because of his age. He was Jesus' older brother. He was the patriarch in the church when it was still there in Jerusalem. Acts 15, verse 13, after they had been silent, James answered and said, men and brethren, listen to me. And you go to Acts 21, verse 18, on the following day, Paul went in with us to James, and the elders were present. It's always James and the elders. Galatians 2:9, and when James, Cephas, that was another term for Peter, and John, who seemed to be pillars, perceived the grace that had been given to me. Always mentions James first. Now, I don't think James is the one the church is built on. Bible's pretty clear. The church is built on Jesus Christ. He is the foundation stone, not any man. Christ is the head of the church. In fact, the title of Pope was unknown to the Apostle Peter. It's a term that has been rarely applied as the official title until the late 11th century. Moreover, no early Christian taught that the primacy supposedly had been given to Peter and then transmitted to successors. Hence, the German scholar Martin Hengel, he concluded that there is no demonstrable historical and theological way to arrive at what later became papal primacy. Jesus unquestionably did build his church, his true congregation, upon himself. Just look at Ephesians chapter 2, verse 20. So if you want to understand these things, there's a little evolution of how this papal primacy developed. 55 through 64, the apostles and Peter, they write throughout the New Testament that the only foundation of the Christian congregation is Jesus. And Stephen, the bishop of Rome, is one of the first ones who said that the bishops of Rome are the successor of Peter. But that was rejected by the other bishops during the same time. 296, now we're about 300 years after Christ. 304 is the first known inscription using the word Papa or Pope. That didn't even appear until nearly 300 years after Christ. So there is not an unbroken succession for the Catholic Church back to Jesus and the apostles. Then you start seeing Pope Gregory the VII. He declares that the Pope is an exclusive title for the Bishop of Rome. Then by 1870, at the First Vatican Council, they declare the Roman Pontiff is the successor of the Blessed Peter. And part of this was to combat the growing Protestant movement. They were saying, you don't have to be a Catholic to be connected with the original primitive church. Catholics were saying, no, we hold the keys to the kingdom. And so, was Peter the first pope? Categorically, you can say no. According to history, according to their own teachings, according to the Bible, Peter is not the first pope. Neither is there a succession of popes from Peter on to the present day. It's not taught anywhere in the Bible. 1 Corinthians 3, verse 9 through 11, "For we are God's fellow workers, you are God's field, you are God's building. According to the grace of God that has been given me as a wise master builder, I've laid the foundation and others build on it. But let each one take heed how he builds on it, for no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ." Christ is the Petros upon which the church is built. He is the Messiah that Peter, the Petros, talked about. And that's what Jesus was saying. Friends, if you'd like to understand more about this subject, we have a very good prime offer for you, a premium offer. It's our DVD called The Revelation, The Bride, The Beast, and Babylon. You watch this, there'll be no doubt in your mind about church history and who is the foundation for the church. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us and link us, pass it on to your friends.